Captain Jack Crocker is our mysterious visitor. He was the only one around at the time of the murder.
This Crocker, do you think...
It would be interesting to meet him. Our young friend should be able to find him. Wiggins, could you find a way to bring this Captain Crocker here to us?
Here? Holmes, that could be dangerous.
No problem, Mr. Holmes.
Mr. Holmes, I was informed that you were looking for me, and I'd like to know why.
Yes, it is important that we talk. You will soon understand why. You are acquainted with Lady Mary Brackenstall, are you not?
Yes, I think I do remember her, from when I was first officer, but I still don't see...
It seems your relationship went beyond that of mere passenger and first officer.
How dare you!
Indeed, how reckless a feeling is love, particularly if one is prepared to commit a murder in its name.
Explain yourself this instant.
You are aware that the murder made the headlines of the morning press. You read the newspaper report, but to your dismay, found it much fabricated. Once you learned that I wanted to see you, you came straight away. You needed to know what I had found.
You? And what do you know?
That evening, you were with Lady Brackenstall, despite the danger.
I'm not afraid, Mr. Holmes. Besides, all of this is just guesswork.
You would be right if there was no evidence.
What then?
Lady Brackenstall was tied to a chair on the night of the murder. And it was you who tied her up.
You call that evidence?
Yes, as she was tied with a sailor's knot. Your handiwork.
So, it's a sailor who's done it. That proves nothing, Mr. Holmes. I'm not the only sailor in London right now. Your theory is flawed anyway. On the night of the murder, I was aboard the Shark. I was supervising the repair of a porthole.
At night?
It was an emergency. There was a leak. You can ask the ship's carpenter. He can confirm.
I'm sure that he can.
Perfect. In that case, we have nothing more to talk about. Good evening, gentlemen.
Holmes, what should we do now? Would you like to check his alibi?
No. There is no doubt that these men will testify in his favour, and there will be no way to check.
So what then?
So we must work with what we have. We have all the puzzle pieces.
Now I understand why you dissected the bell rope.
Wiggins, could you ask Mr. Crocker to come here again, please?
Right away.
Why did you make me come here again, Mr. Holmes?
It is over. I know that it was you who killed Sir Eustace Brackenstall.
What?
I know, because of the height at which the rope was cut. The knife used was a sea knife. The knots were sailor's knots. And not least, the sheer force that was put behind the killing blow. And because you are the only one who knows Lady Mary Brackenstall in London. And because you love her.
It's true.
It is time for you to tell us the whole truth.
I admit that I loved Mary madly from the first day that I met her. But I never did come to visit her, for I believed that she was in a happy household. When I talked to her maid, who told me everything, I was insane with rage. I was due to set sail for 6 months away. I wanted only to see her again. But it turned into a damnable nightmare when he barged in. He dared raise his hand to her. He was not even worthy of licking her boots. Oh, I regret nothing. I admit I killed the monster out of love for her. She will forgive me if she is able.
Lady Brackenstall already forgave you. She said nothing.
Mary.
But that makes her an accomplice as well as her maid. It places her in danger yet again.
Mr. Holmes.
You would not have managed to protect her.
Till I die, do you hear me? Here is a letter that sets everything clear, and it is the one that should be disclosed to the police. I am the only culprit. Mary had nothing to do with it. Now it is time to end this. You should have let me die. How can I live if Mary suffers?
I am sorry, Captain Crocker, but there has been quite enough death in this case. Inspector, I give you Sir Eustace's killer. He tried his best to perform his own justice.
Well, I'm not surprised. Yes, it was me. I confess.
Here is a piece of evidence that can be used in court.
Perfect. A case that went smoothly for once.
Holmes, for heaven's sake, whatever's going on?
Oh, hello, Watson. You're early. Did you kill all of your patients?
What? Holmes, where have all these wretched bees come from?
I increased the temperature of the room so as to prevent them from hibernating. I needed to take a sample of honey. But it worked, Watson. We will have honey all year round.
Ridiculous and dangerous.
They're domestic bees, Apis mellifera, such industrious workers. Anyway, Watson, I am sorry, but I must leave you. I'm in rather a hurry.
You have a new case?
Yes, but nothing as thrilling as this experiment, a theft of plants at the Hanick Gardens in Kew. I'm helping a minister who's an old friend of mine. You can join me if you like.
Well, I'll admit that I'd far rather accompany you than remain alone here with these workers of yours. Besides, you'll need a helping hand with the flowers you're intending to bring back.
Watson, however did you guess?
For the great Sherlock Holmes to bother with the theft of plants. Come on, admit that you're planning to spoil your little bees with some rare pollens.
Since when did I become so transparent? Let us go.
Well, Holmes, here we are at the Royal Botanic Gardens. There's no doubt that this place is beautiful, but are you really intent on investigating the theft of the plants?
Yes, of course.
Don't touch anything else, is that clear? Just go and get a bucket of fertilizer, and without turning it over this time. Good day to you, gentlemen. How may I help you? If you are here for a visit, please do come back on Sunday.
I am afraid that it cannot wait. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend...